SA Counterculture. In the studio today, we have Harmony Woods, three young gentlemen. We have
Audie Ray-Tatnan.
Audie.
Eric Estrada.
Eric.
Nick Sahaki.
And Nick. And the three of them have brought some badass handcrafted wooden products today. Guys, tell us a little bit first about yourselves. Like, how did the three of you meet to create this Harmony Woods thing we've got going on here?
Well, me and Audie met working at Papacito's. We just kind of struck up a conversation about a minor carpentry background, and we were sitting there talking about how much waiting tables really sucked ass.
Just lots of ass. I mean, sucked really, really hard. If anyone's ever waited tables, then they know what we're talking about.
Yes. So
we wanted to get out of that lifestyle, and we figured that doing something of our own, yeah. Anyways. So.
That's always good. And what about Mr. Nick over there?
I met Audie in school at UTSA, and we, last semester, he started the class off by introducing himself as a guy who runs a wooden pipe company.
Oh, nice. Okay, so was the idea already in existence to do the pipes thing before y'all met then?
Yes. I've been making pipes for about 3 years now, and because of that, I've been able to product test over 200 different kinds of woods, just from Colorado Springs to here, you know, just literally grab something and check it out. And so I've been really fascinated by woodworking my whole life, about 10 years. But the company came about 6 months to a year before I met either of these gentlemen. But as I met them and got the perfect team together, it came from a hobby into a business. Because it wasn't really a business before I met these guys.
Right. So what did y'all go to school for, y'all two?
Well, me and Nick went to school and met for entrepreneurship.
Okay, nice. So no real training, hardcore training, like in carpentry or?
Minor experience in carpentry was actually what kind of struck up our conversation at work.
No. So.
Nice. And so you're kind of the, I guess, the woodworker here?
I'm like the shop guy.
Yeah.
Hey, I taught him a ton of things.
Everything I know came from Audie's shop, yeah.
But we also learn from each other, because every day we're trying to push the limits of wood, push the boundaries of what people know, and everything we do is self-taught. There's no book for how to make wooden rings. This is a consumer item that people are going, what is that wood? Because they think it's paint.
Right, you know. Right. So do y'all have other sources that y'all use to kind of learn different techniques or things that maybe, because y'all are obviously still learning as y'all go.
Right, right.
Do y'all have other sources y'all refer to?
I mean, YouTube and Google, yeah. As much as possible.
Google rocks, yeah.
We have some really good people who are pretty experienced on YouTube. And like, for example, we figured out how to finish our rings with CA glue by watching a guy finished his pens that he did for a hobby, and we figured we'd give it a try.
Awesome. Yeah. So a lot of trial and error.
Lots of R&D.
Yeah, hey, let's just test that. Didn't work. Got to try that. That's what I meant. So if you see one product and you go, wow, that's pretty. I mean, I see maybe 20 different renditions before this one because of all the different things we have to figure out. I mean, product development.
Right.
It takes a while.
Of course. So where do y'all get y'all's supplies? Where do y'all get your wood from?
All over, depending on, you know, where we can find it cheapest, but the best selection is down the road at Woodcraft. I mean, not to necessarily give them a shout out, because they are pretty pricey, but they have the best wood room in town. They have, I mean, a couple hundred different kinds of woods, but otherwise, we're going from farmers and ranchers from Wimberley to Canyon Lake for our natural fall mesquite, Texas mesquite. We're going to Allen & Allen Lumber Yard for wholesale large lumber. And for different hardware parts, we're going to any kind of mom-pop store, to Home Depot. So, I mean, we give everybody a lot of business, basically.
Nice. That's awesome. That's awesome. So, tell us a little bit why y'all do what y'all do. We're going to have to wrap up here in a second. But we have to get that out there.
Right.
Let us know the good stuff.
Harmony Woods became a company with the sole purpose of trying to legalize marijuana.
Yeah.
So, because of that, we donate 25% of all of our profits to NORML, the National Organization for the Reform of Marijuana Laws. And we donate to our local Austin chapter because we're really concerned about Texas and Texas's
right.
laws.
That's awesome.
Because we want to see, you know, a better community for our society.
Awesome, yeah. So let us know where we can purchase these kind of things so we can help
of
the
course.
Cause.
HarmonyWoods.org, HarmonyWoods.org, HarmonyWoods.org.
Nice.
HarmonyWoods.org. Nice. Facebook, so, Tumblr, Facebook. Instagram, but all that stuff exists but HarmonyWoods.org.
Perfect. Well, gentlemen, it was great, and we're going to have to test these out before we let y'all out of the studio.
Right.
We've got here some, they call them the Cubans, nice little handcrafted pipes that the wood comes from.
This Seguin. Is from Seguin, Texas. Natural fall mesquite. Locally handcrafted, organically sealed. Extremely durable, and it floats up the river.
Awesome. HarmonyWoods.org. Go get one.